The first thing you want to do is get rid of the top section so you're not having to let a whole bunch of hair up and down each time. Makes it a little bit easier and stops the hair knotting up. I'm actually using a Japanese chopstick to do the separating. It's got a really fine tip, and I'm using a butterfly clip just to keep the hair up out of the way. You can use a separating comb like the hairdressers have. If you're really desperate, you can use a knitting needle, anything that just makes a nice sharp line. We're going to start from the bottom of the head, and we're going to move up in about 1 to 2 centimeters all the way to the top of the head. We're going to comb each section 3 times in 3 slightly different ways. So over here I'm using just some organic conditioner. You can use any conditioner you want. It doesn't really matter because it's just going to be put on and then combed off. Just a small bit towards the top and you can work it down with your fingers. Then using the lice comb, the first way you do it is to place the comb in, stand it up straight and run it down. What we want to see here is the conditioner getting all the way to the top of the comb. What we're not doing is putting it in and taking it straight down like this. So put it in, stand it up, and kind of tilt the comb towards you. What this does is when you're doing it like this, there isn't much of a resistance, but when you put it in and have it up against the top of the comb, it really has the effect of pulling the eggs off the hair shaft. Now this first way of combing is actually the least effective, because when you're putting the comb in and standing it up, it's actually not making contact with the hair shaft until a couple of centimeters down, and the eggs are laid 2 to 5 millimeters from the scalp. So the second way we comb it is we turn the comb parallel, keeping it flat to the scalp and moving along the contour of the head. So we're not putting the comb in and drawing it out towards us. What we want is the root of every hair to pass right through the top of the comb. And you move along 1 centimeter at a time. So we started here, then go here, then here, and all the way along. And the key is to keep the comb flat against the head and along the contour of the scalp. When you've done that, as you're going, you can wipe on paper towel. When you're wiping, you want to keep the comb sort of in an upright position so the conditioner slides off. You don't want to be putting the conditioner flat down and have it all go back in. And then you can run it across and see what you've got. The third way you do is you simply get the teeth of the comb and give it a gentle scratch on the scalp, just a bit like that. What you're doing that for is when the eggs hatch, little baby nymphs are born, the little baby lice are very small, and they feed on your blood, on your scalp. And because they're so small, sometimes they feel like they're stuck to the scalp. Just by giving it a little scratch, you dislodge it from the scalp. And then as you go back and do this parallel motion again, you can pick up any of the feeding lice you may have missed. If at any time you feel like you don't have enough conditioner coming out on the comb, you can add a little bit more, or you can just spray it with a bit of water, because the biggest ingredient in conditioner is water, and that just rehydrates it. When you're satisfied that there's nothing coming off the head after you've looked, you can move on to the next row. If you're still finding eggs, lice after doing that, you do that row again. So you do exactly as you did before, going up about 1 centimeter at a time. It's really important to try and get a really nice, clean part. Just makes it easier to comb. You don't want any bits of hair hanging down or the part to be jagged, because as you run the comb along, you'll hook those bits of hair as you go. So you want a nice, clean line. So once again, get some of the conditioner and you just basically do that process over the whole hair. You don't want too much conditioner. Too much conditioner makes the process really messy. So all we do is we're putting it in, standing it up straight, and running it along. You don't have to wipe after each time, because the conditioner ends up above the comb and up on this handle part, there's no problem of it being reinfected back into the head. Once the eggs are removed from the hair shaft, they can't actually go on to hatch or be back in the head. They're glued on there with like a super glue. So as you pull them off, even if you put them back in the head, they're just going to fall to the ground. being so close to the scalp, the 2 to 5 millimeters, it's your warmth of your head that's incubating that egg in order for it to hatch. So you go back along in this parallel motion again. Any eggs that are further than 2 to 5 millimeters on the hair shaft are most likely to be egg casings. And that means that their louse has hatched out of the egg and it leaves its eggshell behind. And generally the egg casings will be further down, and on dry hair, they'll appear white. On dry hair, the eggs that are unhatched will be closer to the scalp and they'll appear brown. Once you wet the hair, the egg casings, they turn a browny color anyway, a bit like dry skin. If you rehydrate it, it'll turn brown again. Once you're satisfied that it's all clear, basically you go and do the entire head exactly in this way. You start around the neck side, and then it'll turn into like a semicircle. And as you get higher up the head, it'll turn more into a box. Now, if you were to come across and you could actually see one of the eggs really close to the part that you've made and really close to the scalp, what you might find is when you're doing this, the egg is just above the comb and you can't quite hook it out. It's really frustrating because you can see it. But what you need to know is because we're doing each row 3 times, and because we're moving up at about 1 centimeter or 2 at a time, with the width of the comb, you actually will do that row that you've just done another 3 times. So as you move to the next row, any eggs that you've missed here will be caught on the next one. And it's quite deceptive to think that you're going to be able to see every egg. So a lot of people have a good look through their hair and they're like, well, I don't see anything. But it's not until you start combing, well, you may have only been able to see 1 or 2 eggs. As soon as you start combing, suddenly you look on the paper and there's up to 50 eggs. I always go from the motto, for every 1 egg you can see, there's 10 that you can't. Too much conditioner makes the process way too messy. What happens if you're using too much? You'll find that the conditioner slops on the floor, slops onto their clothing. And what's in the conditioner is the evidence. You actually want to know whether you have head lice or not. When you're doing these things, you don't want to do it in the shower, because as you're combing it, all the evidence is just going to go down the drain. Sometimes people have what I call psychological nets, where they think they've got it. Maybe someone in the family's got head lice, and you won't actually know whether or not you've got head lice until you've combed it out. If you've got conditioner slopping on the ground or too much to be able to handle, you won't actually be able to get the evidence which we're collecting in the conditioner. Keeping the comb flat along the head. Now, as we get around here, we'll see that we can no longer keep the comb flat all the way around. We're going to run into her ear. Now, we don't want to run that ear over if we're going to keep it flat. So what we do is we simply turn the comb upside down and go back until we meet where we were. There's no need to do the entire row in 2 different directions. Combing it in the 1 direction like this will remove all the nits. Now, the nits being the eggs, if you've had an infestation for a very, very long time, you might find that you can see the egg casings all the way down the hair shaft. I've done a few cases where there's no way you could put the comb in and start at the top, just because there's too many egg casings. So in that case, if there is a really dense infestation, you'd start at the very bottom of the hair shaft, just removing as much lice and eggs going up until you can drag the comb all the way to the top. Once you get to that point, then you can start the method correctly. Once you get over to the ear here, you're putting the comb in, standing it up straight, but you can't go straight down onto the ear. So you just go over to the top, knowing that maybe not this time we'll be able to go flat, but the very next process when we go up onto the next row, we'll be able to keep the comb flat and get any eggs or anything we may have missed just there. As you're doing the combing process, you're not digging the teeth into the scalp. You're just running the teeth gently across. You can feel them coming in connection with the scalp, but there's certainly no need to dig the scalp in. So over the ear, I just angle the comb, trying to keep it as flat as possible, and going along the hair like that. When I get here, still trying to keep the comb as flat as possible. We really want the root of every hair to pass through the top of the comb. Sometimes in order to get the comb in the right position, I'll just put it up there and slide it in and then put it along like that. In this case, I'll go all the way to about here, turn the comb upside down and go back in the other direction. If the process is taking a little long, what you might find is that conditioner is drying out. So instead of piling more on, just add a little bit of water and you'll find that the comb will slide through really easily. When we're doing the scratch, we're not scratching down into the hair. We're actually trying to dislodge any lice that might be feeding on the scalp at that time. When I'm putting the comb right here, I'm actually only getting the roots of probably the next centimetre or two. You can see down towards the end of the comb, the roots of those hair aren't actually probably going to get right through the top of the comb, which is why when you pull it back to where you started and move along, you'll then get the next group of roots of hair. We basically want to make sure that the root of every single hair on the entire head passes through the top of the comb. So as we're going up to the top, we've turned it into more of a box just because of the way the shape of the head is. So as you do a straight line back, you then can go a straight line across and get it looking a nice even box. And we're going to treat each part exactly the way that we've been treating the parts from the bottom. So we'll go down, across, scratch and across. I always find it's really good to get rid of the corners so we don't have the comb accidentally jagging some of the corners on the way. At this point, you are using maybe about 3 pumps of conditioner just because you've got 3 different sections there. What you might also find is as you let the hair down, there's more and more hair gathering. So sometimes it has a tendency to knot up, also depending on the type of hair your child has. So sometimes what I do is I use a brush just before I start the actual combing and comb out any knots, any tangles that may have come up there. You don't need to worry about any of the lice going from the scalp of the head down into the hair. They're actually here. Where we've put the conditioner on, they'd be stuck in the head right now. And as we use the combing process, there was a louse further down the hair. As we put the comb in and the teeth of the comb are actually staying on the scalp, they're not digging in, they're just on there, and when we pass the comb through the hair, you'd be collecting anything there. There's a lot of hair at this point and you feel like you're really struggling to get it back, just start at the other end. So there's a small section of hair and that begins to get all the hair traveling in the same direction. Once you've done that scratch again and combed through, this section may appear a little too big to actually go straight down the middle. It's a little bit too wide. So what you can do is that you just take a section of that hair and just do the one side and then split this right down the middle and do that last of all, which is what we'll do. So you can see the comb is getting a little bit knotty there. If you feel it's going to be too much, grab the brush, get that through. I'd rather the child, the client, the adult be comfortable than ripping the comb through. There's nothing to gain from dragging it through and hurting them pulling out any hair. In adults, loads of hair comes out. In children, less than a dozen hairs tend to come out, unless they're not kids that brush their hair. Adults get hundreds of hairs out. It's pretty normal. Even up here, we're keeping the comb as flat to the scalp as possible, remembering that it's the eggs and the creatures right close to the scalp that we're trying to get out. So the very last thing that you're doing, you've got this last rectangle of hair up the top, and you're just going to go right down the middle. And you'll do this particular row exactly the same way that you've done the rest of it. So we'll go down, across, scratch and across. Once you've satisfied that you've got every egg, every louse, every egg casing, so after you've done it 2 to 3 times, well, the 3 times minimum and any more that you've had to until it's completely clear, you're left, you've done it to the left and the right, but you might not have been able to get actually right on the part. So the very last thing we do is we give the scalp a little scratch, just training the hair backwards, keeping the comb flat at the top and just slick it back. Now it's really difficult to get the comb completely flat for the whole way, but remember we're just looking at getting the comb through the roots. So you do that all the way along. The last thing I do in preparation to have a good look around the hairline is I comb all the hair back so that it's all the way away from the hairline, just to free it up to have a good look. So what you do now is at about 2 centimeters around the whole head, about from there, you just have a good look to see if you can see any eggs just sitting in that, just those fluffy bits here, all around the perimeter of the head. Once you're satisfied that there's nothing there, you're done.